When Tom finally reached the sleeping hare, he wondered why Harold was napping. That's no way to win a race. Tom tiptoed past him very carefully and very quiet. Harold snorted, but he didn't wake up. The crowd at the finish line started yelling and clapping when they saw Tom. Even though some of them had doubted him, it looked like the tortoise was going to win the race. Tom, Tom, he's our man. If he can't do it, no one can. The crowd cheered. The crowd cheered so loudly that they woke up Harold. He looked around and was surprised to see Tom nearing the finish line. The hare laughed to himself as he hopped to his feet. That silly tortoise still thought he'd win the race. Harold sped off down the track, sure that he would catch up to Tom. But he had an awfully long way to go. Harold suddenly felt very worried. He really shouldn't have stopped to chat with George or to take a nap. What a waste of time. Come on, Tom, the crowd cheered. You're almost there. Tom stretched out his long neck and poked his head over the finish line just as Harold caught up to him. Tom had won the race. That was a great race, Tom said to the hare. No hard feelings? You beat me fair and square, Harold admitted. I may be fast, but I'm not always very wise. Slow and steady beats hurried and careless. From that day forward, Harold worked hard at everything he did. The tortoise and the hare became great friends and lived happily ever after.
All right, on the next slide, you are going to summarize this ending. Be sure to include how's the problem resolved, how did the characters change, and what is the moral of this fable?